students, let's continue with the chapter direct and inverse variation. In this video, we'll discuss more questions related to this chapter. Question number one: A train 350 meter long crosses an electric pole in 28 seconds. Find the speed of the train in kilometer per hour. So here we have to find out the speed of the train in kilometer per hour. So we will let the distance traveled by the train in 1 second. Let distance traveled by the train in 1 second, that is equal to x meter. Now, train is crossing a electric pole. So what will be the distance traveled by the train to cross the electric pole? Since it has negligible dimensions, that distance traveled by the train to cross the electric pole is equal to length of the train. So distance traveled by the train to cross the electric pole, that is equal to length of the train, that is equal to 350 meter. Now let's complete the table here. The two quantities we have to take: distance in meter, time in seconds. So the train take 28 second to cross the electric pole. So in 28 second it covered the distance 350 meter. In 1 second, how much kilometer, how much meter it will cover, that we had to find out. Since distance and time vary directly, it is a case of direct variation. In direct variation, x by y is a constant. So 350 by 28 is equal to x by 1. Let's cross multiply it. 28 into x is equal to 350 into 1. X is equal to 350 into 1 by 28. So it is equal to 25 by 2 meter. That means the train covers 25 by 2 meter in 1 second. So speed of the train is equal to 25 by 2 meter per seconds. But we had to find the speed in kilometer per hour. That is, we had to divide meter by 1000 and second by 3600. So that will be equal to 25 by 2 into 3600 by 1000. That is equal to 45. Then now the unit will be 45 kilometer per hour. So this is the answer. Let's discuss the next question. Udit can complete his work in 10 days. What amount of work will he complete in 8 days? So here you have to find the amount of work he will complete in 8 days. So let amount of work he will complete in 8 days x. Now two quantities we have to take: amount of work and number of days. Here the complete work we did not will take as 1, and to complete the work he take 10 days. Now, how much amount he can complete in 8 days, that we had to find out. Since the amount of work done by a person varies directly with the time taken, this is a case of direct variation. So, it is a case of direct variation. In direct variation, x by y is a constant. So, 1 by 10 is equal to x by 8. So, 10 into x is equal to 8 into 1. X is equal to 8 by 10. That is equal to 4 by 5. So, he can complete 4 by 5th part of work in 8 days. Let's discuss the next question. A contractor undertook a contract to complete a part of stadium in 9 months with a team of 560 workers. Later on, he was required to complete in 5 months. How many extra persons should he employ to complete the stadium? So, number of workers he need to complete the work in 5 months, we'll take it as X. Let number of workers required is equal to X. So, here two quantity we have to take, number of workers and number of days. Sorry, number of months we have to take. Since number of persons performing a particular work varies inversely with the time taken by them, it is a case of inverse variation. So we will complete this. 560 workers 9 months, and in 5 months how many workers required? Since it is an inverse variation, then x into y is a constant, is equal to x into 5. X is equal to 560 into 9 by 5. That is equal to 1008 workers. The question is, how many extra persons should he employ? First he had 560 workers. Now he need 1008 workers. So more extra persons he required is equal to 1008 minus 560. That is equal to 448 workers. I think you have understood these questions. This is your homework for today, and that's all for today. Thank you.